It's another day of financial turmoil around the world as President Obama heads to France tonight for an important economic meeting.
That's the G20 summit, of course, which will focus on the troubles in Europe, especially Greece. Correspondent Mark Phillips is in Nice, France this morning with a preview for us. Mark, good morning.
Well, good morning. In fact, the hard talking was supposed to begin here tomorrow when the world leaders gather for the G20 summit, but it's already beginning today. And the reason, of course, is, as you say, Greece, which has decided to put the deal that it's been offered to bail it out to a national referendum. Many people think this threatens an already shaky deal in a shaky world. Greek Prime Minister Papandreou is due here for meetings today, and they're not likely to be quiet ones.
Just last week, people were hoping for a new dawn in Greece. Instead, the question now is how long and how dark the night will be. The Greek cabinet met late into that dark night and came out saying it agreed with the prime minister's plan to put the European bailout deal to the test of a national vote, even though many fear a vote will undermine the deal and could set off a domino effect financial crisis in Europe and around the world. As the rioting of the past few months has shown, the deal could be a tough sell. Greeks are being told they have to take huge cuts in jobs, pay, and pensions as they're part of an arrangement where banks write off half the Greek debt and the big European countries like Germany and France provide huge sums of money. French President Sarkozy admitted he had been blindsided by the Greek referendum requirement. And while every country has the right to run its own democratic affairs in its own way, he says the European deal on the table was the only option. All this is being held against the buildup of the G20 conference here and the demonstrators that always accompany them. This time, the protesters have come from around the world and with ideas, including a so-called Robin Hood tax to tax financial transactions to raise money to address financial problems.
You know, the Occupy movement and this Robin Hood movement here, people are joining forces. They're recognizing the growing inequality, and they need to take action.
It's all high-minded big stuff, but for now, it's all mired in that problem that won't go away. Greece, the little country with the big problem that's threatening to take the big countries down with it. Erica, Chris.
Mark Phillips on the French Riviera for us this morning. Mark, thanks.